I ordered some new clip leads from China, and the prudent thing to do with these is to check the resistance, because quite often they're not crimped super well, so they'll have a high resistance. 308 milliohms. 293 milliohms. 316 milliohms.
The problem with cheap clip leads is they're always just folded over wire and crimped shut, and that doesn't always make a very good connection. So let's re-solder that.
And let's check that again. Huh. 260 milliohms. It should be much less than that. Here's a homemade clip lead. And that reads 19 milliohms.
Well, I didn't know my soldering was that bad.
Let's do a test here. So I'm going to use this benchtop power supply to run 1 ampere through this yellow clip lead, some thin jumper wires, a homemade clip lead, some telephone wire, the clip lead I just fixed, and another one unmodified, and let's see where they get warm.
And this power supply is unregulated, so I'm just going to use a variac to tweak the current to 1 ampere.
So I just gave that a minute, and let's look at it in infrared. And we can see, huh, the wires are warm. It's not so much the clips, it's the wires themselves, but not all of them. So for instance, here I can see this green one, but I can't see the black one that's going across it. Nor can I see the telephone wire. These little jumpers are getting warm. This clip is getting warm. My supply leads are warm, but not the clips.
Well, I guess it's some really thin wire they're using. Okay, let's swap that out for a different wire.
"1.9 milliohms," says this thing. I'm not sure if I can trust it that low, but it's definitely a lower resistance. And now with a 1 amp current going through all of my leads, they'll not just get warm, but basically each ohm will be 1 volt across, so I can just check that with another voltmeter. So the yellow lead now reads 18 millivolts, so it probably has 18 milliohms. And this clip lead reads 0.63 volts, so that's to say this clip lead has got 0.63 ohms, and the green one that I soldered has got 0.3 ohms.
So that wire is probably about 0.3 ohms, and I just stripped the part that I took out, and it's got really thin leads.
So let's check that. This is a metric dial indicator caliper. It looks like those wires are about 0.08 millimeters in diameter. And checking it with the micrometer, that reads 3.75 thou.
So that's what I read. Micrometer doesn't quite go to zero, so I subtracted that, and that's this much, or 0.09271 millimeters. Worked out the cross-sectional area, there's 12 strands, total cross-section, then convert that to square meters. Resistivity, looked it up on the internet, so I should be getting 0.2 ohms per meter, or with a 30 centimeter clip lead length, I should be getting 59 milliohms. But I'm getting a lot more than that.
So with 1 ampere passing through the wire, I'm going to measure the voltage on the wire between the clips where I'm applying the current, so my contact resistance won't matter. And I'm getting 294 millivolts. So this wire has 294 milliohms. But my calculations say 62 milliohms, so I'm off by quite a lot. So maybe I should use the metric number that I had from the calipers, 0.08 millimeters. And now I should be at 81 milliohms, still way off.
Now I've seen cheap cables made of stuff other than copper, but this is definitely looks like copper. It's got the right color. And if I sand it a little bit, let's see, maybe it's just copper coated.
Well, it still looks kind of reddish, but it's got a bit of a silvery sheen to it now.
So let's try plugging the resistivity of iron instead of copper into my formula. And now my prediction is 0.37 ohms versus 0.294 actual, so it's getting fairly close. So does this mean this clip lead wire is made out of iron? Well, here's a magnet. Look at that. It just picks it up, whereas the new wire doesn't get picked up at all. And some of these other clip leads? Yep, iron. Oh, that's the connector.
homemade one, green one, iron. And these nice power supply leads that I bought recently were also getting fairly warm, so let's see. Iron. So I've been getting paranoid and checking various things to see if they're magnetic, so these wires, not this one, not this one, came with a Fnersey scope recently. Iron, at least this part here. This part here, not iron. Older clip leads, not iron. But all the relatively new cheap clip leads, all iron. Looking in my wire stash. Nothing iron in here. Even the newly acquired Chinese ribbon cables. Oh, that's the twist tie on here. Not iron, not iron, not iron. So from checking this and that and the other, basically anything I bought, say, in the last 5 to 10 years with clips on the end of it from China, all iron wire. But nothing else really I found is iron wire except for mouse cables. And that's true for pretty much all the mice I bought in the last 10 years, but it's okay because it only needs to power the mouse. Thankfully, none of my other USB cables are iron. Really, I haven't found any iron other than that power cord 10 years ago and recent Chinese clip leads, all of them. Now the resistance of iron is about 6 times that of copper, so if they hadn't, on top of making it out of iron, made them really thin, they could have gotten away with it. Like, if these strands had been twice as thick, the resistance would have been fairly reasonable. As for my calculation, it predicts a higher resistance than I was actually measuring, but that's because the wire was at least coated with copper, so that would drop it a little bit. And these videos going into some deep dive about something like wire resistance usually don't do super well for me. But the thing is, I've already done all the work for this for myself, just figuring out what the hell is going on, so I figure I might as well film it and put it online too.